Hello, Glamour Ghouls, and welcome back. If you are new here, my name is Midge Munster, and on this channel, we do all things campy, kooky, glamorous, and spooky. I am so excited to be back in front of the camera. I took a week off after Halloween, which was very good for me. But then I had just a lot of things happen. Our bathroom, we had some plumbing issues, and our basement flooded. I got in a car accident. I hit a deer. I am fine. My car is not. So my husband and I have been sharing a car. Just a lot of stuff happened all at once, and everything is fine, but I took the minute that I needed to breathe and recoup and properly grieve the ending of Halloween season. But I am so excited to be back with you now, and whether we are ready for it or not, the holidays are upon us. They are coming. And one thing I mentioned a little bit on Instagram last week is that I am very excited to be implementing some Creepmas again this year, but I also want to keep Kitchmas alive. I absolutely love Christmas. I love retro Christmas. Obviously, I am spooky, but I am also a vintage queen. And for the last 3 years on this channel, we have done Kitchmas content, and I am excited to be bringing that back because it brings me so much joy. So in today's video, we are hunting for some mid-century modern inspired Kitchmas decor. I'm hunting at Target, I'm hunting at Marshall's, Cracker Barrel, a little bit of Walmart, just several different places that we hit today, looking for these mid-century inspired pieces to work into our decor. Of course, if you can find it and afford it, true vintage is always better, but I do really love some of the recreation pieces we've been seeing in the last couple of years, and I really have been loving this like pink and mint color palette. I've been doing this for Christmas the last 2 or 3 years, and I really, really love it. It's fun, it's different, and it makes me happy. And of course, at the end of today's video, I will show you a little haul of everything I picked up while I was out shopping. So without further ado, let's jump right in. We're gonna start at Target. I'll head over to VoiceOver and kind of walk you through the shopping, and I will see you back here for the haul. So starting at Target, we had so many cute pillows. This is over in like the Threshold kind of homeware section. And usually I don't start here, but I was pulled in by all the wonderful colors. They have these great pillows with the pinks and teals and reds. I really liked the back of this Oh What Fun pillow specifically, and I'm still kind of kicking myself for not buying one. This is also where they always have all of this beautiful mercury glass options, and this is one of my favorite ways to decorate and make a kind of vintage feel is with mercury glass and vintage glassware. All of this stuff was super fun and kitschy, like this stocking holder definitely has a Putz House vibe. These pillows, even though, again, they have kind of a Scandinavian feel more than a vintage, they could definitely work because of this kind of vintage looking more like tacky embroidery style. I love it. They had a couple of these aluminum trees, a big one and a small one that definitely look of the era, and I loved these. Cute, again, just so many cute pillows. This fa-la-la-la-la one was adorable. So then moving into the decor section, they had these blow molds. I really love this reindeer. It's so cute, and they all do light up. Blow molds are a really fun way to give a vintage feel to a room, and they're definitely making a comeback. Then we have these ceramic Christmas trees. You've seen that pink one, actually. They had this last year, and I do have the pink one. If you check out my Kitchmas haul from last year, we bought one of those, and they do have the traditional version as well in green. And then, of course, lots of bottle brush tree options. Always a great way to jazz up a mantelscape, or if you do a mid-century village, those are great. Here is a really cool mercury glass Christmas tree. I loved this. It was pink, and they had a lot of color options as well. This line was kind of more of a like a Heige type cozy, again, kind of that Scandinavian feel, but it had a lot of vintage pieces like these Putz houses. Super, super cute, and definitely in the right color scheme, as well as some of these reindeer sculpts that I thought looked very vintage. The faces on these have the kind of right shape for that era with the pointed nose. This is one of my favorite areas to kind of scavenge through as well, the ornament section. So they have these
$2 and $3 ornament bins. I get a bunch of these spiky ones every year and decorate with them. They are super fun and cheap and an easy way to give mid-century feel to things. I also found this cute little TV set with the little reindeer in it, and I just thought this was super cute. Then moving into kind of the kitchenware section, I was psyched to see a cookie press like this. This is definitely retro, and I mean, obviously that one isn't, but if you were doing like a Christmas party and looking for an activity to do, making a bunch of press cookies like that for a vintage party would be so fun. And then of course you can have your little Christmas Pyrex to put them in. Or if you wanted to go more not so expensive, they always have these really cute cookie tins available. I usually stock up on these every year and use them to make cookies to give to my friends and family. They also have these really cute paper kind of takeout box ones that have reflector ornaments and some cute vintagey napkins as well. They also have this wreath that was, I thought, kind of fun, but then it did start singing and I didn't like that. But if you have kids, this would be really cute. The ornaments do like kind of move their mouth and sing. They had this ribbon mic and this kind of vintage looking radio. I see these radios a lot at like TJ Maxx and Marshall's every year, but these are a really cute kind of vintagey looking tabletop piece. And then I was really excited to see this. They had these snow blankets to lay down. My grandma used to have these, the flake snow like that as well. And then of course they have all these garlands and things, but I was very excited to see bags of loose tinsel like you could hang on a real Christmas tree. That is so, so vintage. I love that. Then in the kitchenware section, they had a couple of plates that I liked. These reminded me very much of like vintage Christmas cards, and I just loved the illustration style. They had the one with Santa and his sleigh, and then they also had this one where he's like carrying packages and kind of sliding on the snow. They also had these great pink snowflake placemats, and I thought these would be really great. They were only like $2 a piece, I think. And of course you could use them as a charger for setting a table, but you could also definitely use them for something else, like hanging on a wall, a nice cheap option. Now that we've seen everything Target has to offer, let's take a quick pause and hear a word from today's sponsor.
Today's video is brought to you by HelloFresh. Let's face it, the holidays are upon us, and while they are wonderful, they can also be hectic. Especially if you are like me and you are a hostess by nature, my house becomes a madhouse during this time of year because family's coming over, friends are coming over. I have too much on my plate to think about what I'm gonna put on my plate. That is why I love HelloFresh, especially at this time of year. It is delivered right to my doorstep, and there are so many delicious meal options. I don't know about you, but the last thing I want to do around Thanksgiving is go to a grocery store. Have you been to one recently? Nuts! HelloFresh eliminates the need for me to go to a busy grocery store, and I also love that it helps me keep my kitchen clean because the ingredients come pre-portioned, ready to cook. You chop up a few vegetables, toss it in a pan. It's so easy and the food is so good. I know what stopped me for a long time from trying HelloFresh was that I was a little worried that like the portions wouldn't be enough for me and my husband because we like to eat. But after every HelloFresh meal, I feel full and satisfied. And have I mentioned that the food is delicious? And because HelloFresh sends me exactly how much I need of each ingredient, it helps me reduce my food waste and eat more sustainably. So this holiday season, give you or someone you love the gift of time saved, money saved, and eating deliciously. So go to HelloFresh.com right now and use my code MidgeMunster14 for 14 free meals plus 3 free gifts. That's 14 free meals plus 3 free gifts at HelloFresh.com with my code MidgeMunster14. Thank you so much to HelloFresh for sponsoring today's video. Now, let's get back to the Kitchmas hunt.
After Target, I headed to Cracker Barrel and was pleasantly surprised to see they had a Kitchmas line. They have this very cute pastel blue and pink line, some cute stand-up signs. This was a very cute little nutcracker, very heavy too. And this actually looks a lot like some stuff that Macy's is doing this year, but at like a quarter of the price. So if you've seen that line from Macy's and you've been you know, intrigued by it, check out Cracker Barrel. They've got some cute stuff that kind of looks like a dupe of that, but much cheaper. And of course, we have another Putz house. I feel like that's a must-have for these types of Christmas lines. And then I just adored this little reindeer plate. I don't know why. They were, I think, yeah, $4.99 a piece. And I just thought those were so precious. I loved that design of the reindeer. They also had this very cute aluminum style wreath with ornaments on it that would fit in my color scheme. I really liked that, but I don't need another wreath. I have several already. And then, oh my gosh, I was so excited to see this. A Merry Christmas pillow with starbursts and a pink bug. Oh my gosh. For those of you who don't know, I drive a Beetle and I am always on the lookout for Beetle decor. So, so cute. They have this fun fiber optic kind of silver white tree and some really cute ornaments on it. As you saw, there was that little Putz house ornament, some really cute reindeer, and they did have some really pretty kind of replicas of reflector ornaments, or like this piece that looked very much like things my grandmothers used to have on their trees. I really liked those. They made me feel nostalgic for sure. Then there was this cute little deer magnet. I don't know what I would use it for, but it reminded me of like chalkware from the 50s, and I liked it a lot. Oh, I was obsessed with this reindeer mug, and I'm still kind of bummed I didn't get it, but the sculpt on that is very cute for $6.99. They also had pajamas with little Putz houses and kind of what looks like little bottle brush trees on it, and I thought those were so cute too. So then I headed to Marshall's. I was looking for something specific at Marshall's that I didn't find, but I did find a couple more of these radios in the color scheme this time, in this mint rather than the red that Target had. They had two variations of that, and I really liked that first one, the Snow Tunes. That's really, really cute. But unfortunately, Marshall's didn't have a lot that fit in this theme. I was looking for a specific snow globe that one of you sent me in my DMs, and it was so cute and kitschy and had reindeer in it, but I did not find it here, unfortunately, on this day. So after Marshall's, I headed to At Home, and I went to look at their Mod Mrs. Claus line because I saw this wreath and assumed it was back, but they have changed it to Mrs. Claus's Bakery. They still have a couple of the pieces, like this piece and the little gals with the cute hair from last year, but no Putz houses, no bottle brush trees in cloches like they had last year. They did have this one blue reindeer, but I did purchase him last season. But it's still part of this Mrs. Claus's Bakery line, but they've made it much more like gingerbread based, and I was just, I don't know, some of the pieces were cute, like that little camper, but I was just really disappointed to see they didn't expand that line further. I thought it was so cute last year. What they did keep from this line was all these ornament options that look like vintage reflector ornaments, and I was really happy to see those back. These are shatterproof, so that's great because vintage ornaments are made of very breakable thin glass, so if you have kids at home or pets, this is a great option to decorate your tree with a lot less risk to your vintage ornaments. The only other thing I saw that kind of had a vintage feel in several different lines, they had these kind of blow mold candles. They had this peppermint one, but the one I thought was really cool were these silver ones because I thought you could really paint these up to look however you wanted to fit within your color scheme. At Home also always carries these great pin tuck pillows. These are not part of their Christmas line. They always have them, but they're super vintage, and I would definitely recommend grabbing a couple in the color scheme. Lastly, I headed to Walmart, and they didn't have a ton. I was sad because I had seen some blow molds and things online from Walmart, but I didn't see any of that today. Just a couple cute things with some vintage looking illustrations, but that is where we wrapped up for the day, so let's head back for the haul.
All right, welcome back. I really hope you all enjoyed searching for some Kitchmas decor out in the wild. I really feel like we found a lot of good stuff. This kitschy mid-century vintage throwback Christmas trend has definitely been popular the last couple of years. I'm really glad to see it still out and about. I will say it's starting to dwindle. Like, I was really disappointed to see At Home not further continue that Mod Mrs. Claus line this year. That Broke my heart. I've been really frustrated with At Home in that regard because they had the Cool Cats line, the mid-century line for Halloween 2 years ago, and then didn't have it at all this year. And then the Maud Mrs. Claus line was really kind of, there was a lot of good stuff to it. It wasn't perfect by any means, but they had a few really solid pieces and I was excited to see them expand upon it. And now they've taken it in a whole other direction again. And it's, I kind of feel like companies don't know what to do with mid-century. Like, they have this like idea of what they think it is, and they have like a couple of pieces on retainer that they're like, oh, we'll make a, you know, reindeer that is pink. And then they kind of like full stop and run out of ideas. And it's just, it's a bummer. Someone hire me. Let me design a line for At Home or Target or somewhere. Let me design some mid-century decor for you because I will kill it. But I did find several pieces that I really loved that I felt like I had to add to my collection. So let's dig into the haul. I feel like this first piece will come as no surprise, and it is this little blow mold reindeer. I think this is so cute, and I love that it's red. I see a lot of pink reindeer, and I have several pink and mint reindeer, but I like to try to add a little bit of red and green softly into the mix, and I just really, I like the sculpt on him too. Like, I like the face. I like that he's in this little bed of snow. He does lay up, of course, like you saw in the footage. My one qualm, I have a qualm, is that I got it home and almost immediately it separated from its stand. So that's a bummer. And they don't have them anymore. I checked, they are already out, so I can't exchange it. I will definitely be able to like super glue it back together. I don't think that'll be a problem, but I was just kind of irritated that I had it for like less than a day and it already broke. So if you buy one of these, be very careful with it. But I am really glad that I got it. It's super cute. In kind of the same vein, I did also get this red reindeer pillow from Target as well. And I love this. I know it's not like technically super vintagey, but it, I mean, this like intense, like kind of overdone, a little bit tacky embroidery style does very much remind me of stuff that like my great aunts and people had. And I don't know, there's something also very much about these reindeer that were a little like Dr. Seuss-ish to me, which I feel like Kitschmas lies somewhere in the realm of vintage Christmas and like Dr. Seuss. Like, we're right in the middle there. And this is that sweet spot for me. I really like this. I like the tassels. The back is cute. It's got this like red snow-flecked pillow. Honestly, the kind of like threshold area of Target had a lot of cute Christmas pillows this year that I could have gone pretty nuts in the way of pillows, but I kept it tame. I only bought one. Still, one of my absolute favorite ways to give like a cozy vintage feel is with glassware. And I did buy this little like gold flecked candle holder. It's got a gold rim on it. I don't know. I really, really liked this. It looked kind of almost a little like terrazzo to me. Like, I know it's not, but it has something about it that feels like I would have found it at like an estate sale. And I think it's very, very pretty. And I can tell that when I put a candle in it, it's going to glow really beautifully in this kind of dimpled glass. Like I kind of mentioned in the footage, I love decorating with like mercury glass, any kind of vintage looking glassware that just is going to cast a really beautiful, warm, cozy light. That makes me really happy and feels Christmassy to me. So this was just a $10 little candle holder, and I don't know, I found it to be very beautiful, so I got it. Speaking of glassware, I don't know what it was about this, but I had to have it. It's this glass Christmas ornament soap dispenser in red. And I just think this is so pretty. It's just, I don't know. I don't have anything else to say about it except for the fact that I thought it was beautiful. And I love that it has the lights kind of making it look silvery, but it is like a gold topper. And I don't know, this is the kind of stuff I always forget. Like, I never get practical stuff like, you know, soap dispensers, towels. Like, I forget that kind of stuff in my decor. And I saw this and I just thought like, wow, that's really, really nice. And so I think I'll probably put this on the counter in my kitchen. Since my living space is kind of one big open space, I feel like the kitchen always gets a little neglected for decor. And so I think this will help bring a little pop of cheer to that area. Next, just kind of a small thing, were these little ornaments, which I showed in the film. I love these. They've never done these before that I remember, and I think these are so cute. Very, like, sculptural. They remind me of kind of like an Eames lantern type thing. Like, just very cool and sharp lines. Very mid-century feels. Them just being very, like, shapely and sharp lines and sculptural. I am so excited about these. I got three of them. I love to play with Target's ornaments. I think I mentioned it in the footage. They have those, like, spiky starburst ones. And I get a handful of them every year in different colors, and now I probably have like 20. And I'll set them on tabletops. I will hang them on our stocking holder with our stockings. I'll put them on the tree. I'll put them, you know, hanging on garlands. Like, I just love them. I don't know. I think you can really take it from kind of like cutesy to like, oh, there's a vintage through line with stuff like that that's very like specific to the era. This isn't the most exciting thing, but I did get one of the snow blankets from the Wonder Shop. This one is the glitter one, of course. And this in particular made me really happy for a couple of reasons. One, I have had a mid-century Christmas village for the last 3 years that I've been slowly growing, and I have needed snow for it. I have never, I've tried like batting and some different things, which that is, you know, to an extent what this is, but it is a little bit softer. It has more give to it. It just never like looked quite right. So I'm excited about this. This is also just like sentimental to me as far as being like vintage. This is sadly going to be our first Christmas without my grandmother, and this made me think of her because she always had like a little village set up on their fireplace, like hearth. They had this low hearth on their brick fireplace, and it had this kind of snow blanket with the glitter flecks on top, and then she would decorate it with little tchotchkes and put our presents up there. And she always used to like put little clues, like she would put the way she would wrap, she'd put little, you know, tchotchkes and things on the outside of our presents to give like clues as to what was on the inside. And so like just seeing those really specific presents in front of the snow blanket and everything just brings me like warm fuzzies to my heart. And so I had to get this because it just made me really happy, and feel like this will be my little small tribute to my grandma this Christmas. All right, so next I have this really beautiful little aluminum type tree. This looks so much like my aluminum tree, like my vintage aluminum tree. It's so cute. Just a little tabletop tree. It's on this like wooden base and has these bulbs that are like permanently attached to it. They're not hooks, they're like clipped onto it, so they don't go anywhere if you shake it around, which is nice. And I love that they're already in my color scheme. It's like the blush and the pink and the blue and the green and the red. Super, super cute. The tree is silver but has like a slight reflection of gold to it, and the base is gold, so it definitely fits into the theme. This would be something really awesome if you have like a small studio apartment or something where you don't want to have like a big tree. This definitely gives that vintage Christmas feel without having to make a big space commitment. So for $20, this is a great, great option. And the last thing I got from Target, I feel like you will not be surprised to see it all. And it is this little Merry Christmas sign with the little beetle carrying a Christmas tree. I had to get this. As like cute as they are, it is very infrequent that you see stuff with beetles on them. And I used to collect Beetle Volkswagen like models and toys when I was a kid. I wanted one my entire life. I got one when I turned 18, and I still to this day drive a Beetle. When I traded in my first Beetle, I got another Beetle. I am the Beetle lady. Like, I love them. I think they are the cutest car in the world. And like, this is me in a Christmas decoration. This is me in a sign. Like, it's a Beetle. It's Christmas. It's the kitschy pink and mint color palette. It's got glitter. I love it. I love it. I love it. I cannot wait to hang this. It's even got little kind of like retro-y, I think it's supposed to be snow, but it's got like kind of retro-y pink starbursts all around it. The font is very like cute and mid-century looking. I just... I almost didn't see this. I went to the like back aisle where like the gardening stuff is, and this just happened to be hanging back there. And I was like, thank God I like walked around the corner. Because there was no other Christmas stuff there, just like this sign and one other sign, and I would have missed it. And this was only $5. I had to. It's so cute. And then I only got one more thing. It's not necessarily Christmas related, but it is a Starbucks Christmas cup. And I have been seeing these cups online, and I really wanted one. Again, it's something about that like vintage looking glassware that makes me feel very like, And so Starbucks put out these kind of retro looking jeweled tumblers in different colors. And I went to Target and they only had out the red and the green. And I was like, okay, like the red's cute, but I don't know if I need it. And I left and I forgot. The whole reason I had gone to Target was to get a storage bin for some of my Halloween stuff. So I went back like an hour later, and while I was walking out with my storage bin, a woman was stocking the pink cups at the Target Starbucks. Look how cute this is. I love it. I literally never luck out with these Starbucks tumblers. I feel like they are really hard to find because people like buy them up and resell them. So I felt very lucky to find one. And my favorite cup that I drink out of every day is a Starbucks tumbler. It's this like black studded iridescent one. And actually one of y'all sent me this last Christmas. It is my favorite thing. I carry it with me every day. And now I have another one, which means this one can take a little breather sometimes, which is good. I feel like this is the two sides of my personality hanging out together. But anywho, very, very excited that I found this. And it does, it just, for some reason, it gives me cozy retro feels, so. Here's the thing, at the end of the day, there's a lot of people who are vintage purists, and that's fine. Like, I respect you, but I also really like my version too. I have some really beautiful vintage pieces that I've been able to find here and there over the last couple of years, but I really do love this like weird, kitschy, like I said, somewhere in between retro and Dr. Seuss place that I found in Christmas, and it makes me really happy. And I really hope that you all enjoy it as well. So that is it for today's video. Thank you so much for watching. I'm excited to start sharing all the holiday content I have with y'all. We will do another one of these hunting videos, but I filmed all the Creepmas stuff I found in the wild as well. Not just like Nightmare Before Christmas type stuff, but also just dark aesthetic Christmas. Quite a few places are airing to the like using black as a Christmas color this year. And so I found a lot of great finds. So we will be doing a secondary video to this as well with some of those goodies. And we are going to start decorating for Christmas pretty soon as well. So I'm very excited to do that with y'all too. We've got some decorating videos coming up. We've got some DIY videos for both Kitchmas and Creepmas. Overall, it promises to be a very fun like month and a half, so I hope you will stick around. Remember, if you would like to try HelloFresh, you can head over to HelloFresh.com right now and use the code MidgeMunster14 for 14 free meals plus 3 free gifts. And of course, if you haven't already, be sure to subscribe to the channel before you leave today. We would love to have you as a part of our Glamour Ghoul gang. Thank you all so much for watching. I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day. And until next time, keep it campy, kooky, glamorous, and spooky. Bye!